So we are right about to start with the last talk of the session. Please take your seats. And the talk is about Fossology project given by Michael Jäger and Maximilian Huber. Let's welcome the speakers.
Thank you. Actually, the talk at 5:40 already said thank you to the persons who still left. So I'm wondering what to say for the persons who stay until 6:40. Thank you very much, anyway. So we are Maximilian and me, Michael. We both work on the open source project Fossology, and we would like just to introduce it today very briefly in 15 minutes. We are very happy to have the opportunity. And yeah, let me start. So Fossology is about this notice file thing. I guess you have seen maybe in open source projects already examples about notice files. One more popular notice file appearance are the legal parts in smartphones. If you are interested in this like about section, and then you see some legal section, and then you see a lot of licenses. And these are actually the licenses of the involved open source software. And the basic problem is, if you have larger software today, obviously you use a lot of open source software, and if you would like all to print all the different licenses, then you need to collect them, and probably you would like to have some software for that. And this is what Fossology is about. So it's basically about licenses. If you are into the open source software licensing, there are two areas where you would like to deal with scanners. One scanner finds open source software that has been copied maybe to private proprietary products. And the other thing is just finding the license statements in open source software. Fossology is about finding license statements in open source software. And why is that so difficult? Because open source software today is made of other open source software. So if you have an open source package, it's natural that you find pieces of other packages in that open source package. And as such, because different packages have different licenses, you will find also different licensing conditions for different parts of your open source software. That's why you would like to have software scanning it. So that's one problem you have. I have here a screenshot, probably you can't even read it. It's about Apache Thrift. You would think that this is an Apache Foundation project. Usually they are well curated about licensing, but this one has 20 different licensing statements for different parts inside the software, because Apache Thrift is about remote procedure invocation on different programming languages, and that involves different technology stacks, so you have different licenses. So that's one problem. And maybe you would say, okay, so what? So you collect all the different licenses, write some regular expression scanning thing, and then you get all the licenses of your open source software involved. The next problem is that licensing statements are usually not so easy to understand. So I have a couple of examples that should kind of explain what the real problem with finding out proper licensing is. Here we have a licensing from Out of the Wild, from TrueCrypt software. It's actually very good software. I've used it myself. No offense against TrueCrypt. But the licensing here is very confusing, because they're saying like, oh, this software is actually based on some other software, but we license our software on TrueCrypt licensing. And then you find out, okay, but what was the license of the other software, by the way? And you start researching on this. Another example is that some persons just like software for write software for fun, and then they do licensing statements which are also fun, right? So this guy, and that's also a real example from Out in the Wild, it's from the zlib library, which is used at many places for just doing zlib compression. And this guy says, like, if you're a fan of Che Guevara, don't use my software, right? And you can do that, but the point is, this statement is really hard to find by scanners, right? So you need to look at the statement. Maybe if you have real commercial software you want to sell in 100,000, or so do you ask your lawyer. If you are an open source project, you say like, oh, that's fun, let's make another fun out of it, and you start another funny license like chocolate license or beerware license or whatever. But if you want to cope with it, somehow you come across this one. There are two other examples which make it more complicated. Here you have a common license text. It's called BSD license if you are into licensing. And then they have added to the license text another paragraph saying, oh, if you don't own licensing, you can also go for GPL licensing. This is because you want to be compatible maybe with GPL licensing and so on. But the fact is, this is a very custom statement about licensing, and it's really tough to write scanners to automatically identify these and interpret on these. And then there are even nasty, more nasty things. This is a common license text here. It's also an example from open source software, which is on GitHub. I didn't put the source here because I don't want to blame the vendor here. But this is about in MIT licensing. It says you can do basically with the software whatever you want. Just tell who wrote the software. And then they have added to a standardized license statement special sentence saying like, yeah, but you can only use the software on our hardware, right? Or you can only use that software if you communicate with our hardware. And that is really a huge limitation, and you don't get it if you just scan for licensing statements, because a stupid scanner would probably find this licensing. And that's where Fossology kicks in. Fossology is not only scanning, because frankly today there are a lot of open source scanners today. There are fast scanners, there are scanners in Python, there are scanners in Java. You will find a lot of open source projects doing scans in open source software. But Fossology is about scanning and review. So that's a major difference to other projects. It's not only about scanning, but it's also if you have these ambiguous cases, you have an UI and can review what licensing you find in the software. So now I'm heading over to Maximilian.
So is it working? Yeah. I will tell some core facts about Fossology. It's open source. That's great. It's, in fact, even a Linux Foundation collaboration project. So it's the Linux Foundation supports the project. And it's GPL v2 licensed. So it will stay open source. And it's a Linux application which is mostly written in C and PHP. It has around 100,000 lines of C and 100,000 lines of PHP. The graphical web front end runs on Apache, and there's also a command line interface which can be used if one wants to have automated scans or want to get the information into some other systems. It can be accessed via the command line. The backend of Fossology is also very interesting. It contains a scheduler which runs agents in parallel and allows to, so if you have a huge chunk of code, you can upload it and say, I want these three scanners to be run on this upload, and then you can come back later once they are done. And we have PostgreSQL as database, and we have scripting for Docker and Vagrant. If one wants to just try it out or to deploy it, that makes it easier. So that are just some facts. Now I will try to actually show the application. Yeah, it's working. Is it readable or is it too small? So
make it smaller, yeah.
So actually, one would need a larger resolution for that, but I will try to work with that. So I have just uploaded two random packages, time and setlib. And now I can, for example, open the time library. And as shown previously, one can at one look see which statements might be contained, which licenses might be contained in the source code, and with this information, one can now try to find interesting copyright statements. For example, here there is some MIT license, and that is found correctly. And let me just switch to the more interesting setlib example. So here we see we have many setlib possibilities. That's one of the features of Fossology that for Fosoji already knows Zlib or the special parts of Zlib, and that the special thing in Zlib is that it says, if you want to know what the license situation is, look in the zlib.h file. And just to demonstrate what Fosoji can, I can now take this sentence and say, hey, this sentence is used often here, and I know what I'm doing. So every time I see that sentence in a file, I will say the zlib possibility was right, but I know it even better. I can say it's real zlib, and then I can say do that and look at each file and why is there Apache 2? Oh, I think I have clicked something wrong.
But you can correct it with the same method, right?
Yeah. That's interesting. I think I can remove licenses here for the whole. To demonstrate another feature, I can say, I know that in the whole project there is no Apache 2.0. And then it's gone. So, and with this workflow, one would work through the whole package until all things are green on the right side. And after that, one is sure that all possible license statements were controlled and were cleared. And there are also further there's also a UI to handle copyright statements and to clean them up, since they often contain some rubbish which can be removed, and also other features. So that's Fosoji. And then another feature of Fosoji. Now one has the clearing. One has all the information in the system. And then there are how to tell others about the gained information. And for that, Fosoji supports SPDX, which is a format. I think it's created by a group by the Linux Foundation. Is that right? Yeah. And it's also supported by many other tools, so you can export the license information. You can even process it with your own tools, which might understand the XML RDF standard. And the next big step is company A has generated such an SPDX file, and it hands it to you. And you want to know whether it's right or wrong. And for that, you can also use Fosoji. So you would take the provided SPDX file and upload it into the system. Then you would go to this exactly the same UI as here, but now you would see only the provided license information, and you can use the same UI to verify the SPDX file provided to you. And yeah, that was just another feature of Fosoji. It's really huge, and we have many, many features, and it makes fun to explore them all. And thanks, I think. Thanks. You can try it if you want by this simple line of Docker. You get a pre-built image of the latest master, or you can just visit one of the URLs to get further information. And now I think we
questions,
might have...
if there are. Jan.
How does the workflow look like if I'm uploading the next version of a package? So the typical case of I want to verify if the information changed over the next month.
Yeah. So the question was, if I have an analysis and looked at one file or one upload, and then I'm uploading a newer version of the same package, so Fossology can do a couple of things to reuse information from the existing upload. First of all, it stores every file only a single time on the file system by hashes. So if a same file is part of a different upload, it takes the hash and takes over information which I have originally assigned to a file with a certain hash. So if that file has been already on a server being analyzed, it appears in the same form at the newer version, it will be taken over. But also the custom formulations, and that was probably also one important thing here with this presentation, license statements are normally written in like just prosaic language, right? And as such, if you have an open source project, you find these prosaic statements and you would like to tell the system if that prosaic statement is actually found in a file, then it's GPL. And that is what you can do with this interface of Fossology. And you can reapply these rules, like identified text phrases hinting to a license to a new upload, so you do not need to make the work again. So that's why Fossology is also a server-based application with multi-user, even multi-groups, and so on. So that one big server just collects your analysis, and if you upload newer versions of that, you really need to look into new licensing statements that are found in newer versions of open source packages. I'm okay to have two more questions. But maybe just one quick. Ah, interesting. True. Yeah, frankly, you know, NPM is not really the domain, the problem domain, because many packages have clear licensing in the beginning. It's really like the classic Linux or Unix packages that you find in this embedded systems programming. Also, for example, if you are a fan of Spring Framework, and they are very well licensed, very cleanly licensed. So for the clean licensing thing, Fossology isn't fun, right? You're just uploading and you see always the same license, and then you say like, okay, what do I need to do here? But it's really for the classic C library that has been grown over many years, and you find 10 different licensing statements, and you would like to get a clean impression about the licensing situation. So NPM, I think it's also obvious, half page of JavaScript code, one liner of licensing in the beginning, so. Scott is not my opinion. No, we don't, but Fossology, actually, if you look for licensing statements, you can do many things. You can search for keywords, so you will find a lot of licensing statements, but you don't know which licensing or which license it is. And if you review these, you need to determine which license it is. So Fossology can do both. You have keywords that hint at license-relevant text statements. You have full license texts, like 400 full license texts, and you can do text matching, and it shows to you 100% match. So you know that the license is actually in the open source package code base. And it does also some sentence characteristic sentence matching in the middle, which is not really like giving you the security or certainty that the certain text is actually there, but it hints very precisely at that this licensing is actually found. So it has keywords, regular expressions covering a couple of words, and full license text matching.
I think we have to close. We will stay here in the middle, in the front, since this is the last talk, and we'll answer further
questions.
Well, we
need to close the room, but...
Oh, to close the room. So we won't stay in the room, but we will answer questions.
Is there anywhere people can find you, either today or tomorrow?
Legal dev room. Legal and policies dev room. That's where you find. And
if you use Fossology, and some of them seem to have used it, as I see, you can have stickers. We have stickers now, and please talk to me if you want to have a sticker.